17, you are the Extreme Universe. We are here in New Orleans, Los Angeles. As seen just a few moments ago, the Extreme Diva herself, Lita, has now been confirmed to be in charge of the new women's division here. And we have got a few matches lined up here tonight. Let's just waste more time and just get into it. And here we go with our first match of the evening. This New Orleans crowd is very showing their opinions of this man here. He is a former WWE World Heavyweight Champion, the first man to ever cash in at WrestleMania, and also the first ever man to cash in during the match itself. He is the architect of the Shield, Seth friggin' Rollins. As you hear, the New Orleans crowd are definitely showing their devotion to Seth Rollins. You could just hear the boos, probably from even outside the building. As we continue EHW Championship tournament for the EHW title, let's just bring out the second opponent of this match. Seth Rollins ready to go. Let's bring out Sheamus. The lights go out. You see all this Celtic member, all this Celtic crosses, and here is him himself, the bionic redhead, the Celtic warrior, Sheamus. Sheamus looks ready to go. I would also like to take this opportunity to know if you wanted to talk about EHW on Twitter, use the hashtag EHWTalk @TheLucky13Gamer to find out more about EHW. Thank you. And as we see, Sheamus is about to get in the ring. I'm very looking forward to this match. Whose kick would be better, the super kick, so to speak, or the bro kick? Let's get this match started. Here we go. This will be Seth Rollins versus Sheamus. Let's ring the bell. And a nice head dot there by the architect of the Shield, Seth Rollins. Nice elbow to the back of the head of Sheamus. Oh, Sheamus pushes Seth to the ropes, throws him off, ducks underneath. Oh, what amazing agility there by Sheamus. Did not expect that from Sheamus. Seth Rollins was able to reverse it into a hip toss. Elbow type again. This time Seth Rollins is able to grab the arm. Just making more pressure to the arm of Sheamus. Oh, Sheamus is able to find a way out of it. Got him in some sort of arm lock there. Oh, nice drop kick there by Seth Rollins. As you see, both these men are just... Oh, nice hit security. As I was saying, both these men were showing off. As we all know, both these two men are both very confident in themselves. Oh, nice reversal there by Seth Rollins. Nice right hand. Second one. Nice spinning kick. Oh. What's Seth Rollins going for here? Oh, just driving the neck of Sheamus right into the bottom rope there. Brutal move. Oh, Seth going for a nice reverse DDT there. So it looked like. Oh, Sheamus just throws him over. Gets him up. Oh, nice roll up. There by Seth Rollins. Two. Oh, I almost thought Seth nearly had it and the quick early pin. Caught Sheamus off surprise. Quick two count. Oh, a nice form leg. Nelson suplex. Sheamus is able to kick out. I think it's all been Seth Rollins in this match. Nice right hand. Sheamus able to brush it away. Oh, try to throw him over there. Oh, nice spinning heel kick. Throws him on the ropes. Throws him off. Jumps over. Oh, a nice one-legged drop kick there for the Architect. Nice reversal there by Sheamus. Oh, throws him over for a snap, man. Oh, nice chin lock there by Celtic Warrior. Oh, more pressure. Sheamus is making this very painful for former WWE Champion. Actually, now think about it, both these men are actually former World Heavyweight Champion. Sheamus actually, oh wait, never mind that. Oh, nice. Vada Kedavra there by the Architect Seth Rollins. As I was saying, Sheamus actually won it off this man's former best friend, Roman Reigns. It's Survivor Series, after he won the Money in the Bank contract. But never mind that, Seth Rollins just throwing Sheamus right out of the ring. Seth Rollins is looking for it. I think he wants to take a risk. Bounce off the ropes. Oh, just pushing Sheamus right into that barricade there. That's gotta hurt. The Bionic Redhead. Seth Rollins very pleased that he was able to pull that off. Oh, Seth Rollins throwing Sheamus back in the ring. Oh, I think he's looking for that springboard high knee. Oh, but Sheamus was able to knew where he was and knew Seth was going for it, so he moved out of the way. But Seth was able to reverse it to a drop kick. Oh, nice fury of punches there by Seth Rollins. Oh, but Sheamus is now able to reverse it. Oh, a nice uppercut there by Sheamus. Oh, nice fury of kicks to the gut of Seth Rollins. Kick knee to the head. Oh, Sheamus looking for a back breaker. Oh, I just crushed in the back there of Seth Rollins. Gets Seth Rollins up. Nice headlock. Oh, another knee to the head. Oh, Irish whip into the corner. Oh, what Sheamus looking for here. Puts him on top. Oh, I think Sheamus is looking to do large amount of damage. Oh, nice back suplex there by Celtic Warrior. Done a bit of damage to himself though. Goes for a quick pin. One. Oh, but somehow, some way, Seth Rollins was able to kick out. Guess that means he was champion for a reason. Both these men cashed in their Money in the Bank to actually win their world titles. Both these men with the two previous. Oh, but never mind that. White noise there by Sheamus. Quick pin. Both these men were one of the few previous owners of the title. But that's not. We're not in WWE anymore, boys. Oh, nice headlock there. Oh. Oh, and just drives Seth Rollins back down to the mat. Oh, I think Sheamus is looking for it. He's looking to knock out Seth Rollins. Oh, nice bro kick there. Straight to the head of Seth Rollins. But only two count. Sheamus doesn't even believe it. I surely thought that was going to be it right there. Oh, gets him up. Oh, nice reversal there by Seth Rollins. Oh, Seth Rollins showing cockiness once more. Oh, nice spinning kick again, and a second one. Oh, Sheamus is able to reverse it. Oh, nice drop kick there. Oh, reversal there by Seth Rollins. Oh, what's Seth Rollins going for here? Oh, a nice slap to the head there of Sheamus. Oh, I think Seth Rollins is looking to end it. And a curb stomp straight to the bionic redhead. Goes for a pin. One, two. Oh, Seth Rollins doesn't. Guess Seth Rollins wants to do a bit more damage to Sheamus. Just waiting for Sheamus to get up now. Oh, nice spin kick. Throws him to the ring. Drop kick. And another. Oh, and a nice spinning neck breaker there to Sheamus. Oh, Seth Rollins getting him straight up. Throws him to the corner. Runs after him. Oh, I think he was looking for that buckle bomb. But Sheamus was able to see it coming. Nice Irish whip into the corner. Oh, nice elbow to the back of Sheamus. Oh, Seth Rollins throws him over. Bit of a stamina issue here. Seth Rollins showing his confidence once more. Throws him under. Lifts him up. And it looks like he's going for the buckle bomb. And he hits the buckle bomb straight into the corner of into Sheamus. Looks like he's gonna end it. Sheamus saw it coming and got up. Oh, and nice fury punches right to the promo zone of Sheamus. Oh, this time I think Seth's going for it. Yeah, leap goes back and drives his head straight to the corner. If I'm not mistaken, I swear I just see blood pouring from Sheamus' head. The pin, one, two, three. And Seth Rollins advances to the semi-finals. He will join Randy Orton and Batista in the semi-finals of this tournament. Well done, Seth. And here's some of the replays in this match. Here we go with that leverage pin. I do believe he was holding the tights. Sheamus is just able to get out. And there's that full Nelson slam we saw earlier in the match. Sheamus is able to get out. And there's that bro kick. The only bro kick we saw actually in this match. Seth Rollins is able to kick out. And I do believe this was the second and last curb stomp that put away the Celtic Warrior Sheamus, and Seth Rollins advances to the semi-finals of this tournament. Well done, Seth. And here we go with our second match of the evening, as promised by our new, well, I guess she's the one who's in charge of the women here in of EHW. Lita, Extreme Diva Lita. And here comes the first competitor in this match. The boss, Sasha Banks. Sasha Banks looks ready to go here. If she does this might be her first title, except for the excluding the NXT title she won against Charlotte a few years back when this was called WWE, this is EHW now, and here comes Summer Rae, obviously wanting to capture her first ever title here in, well, at all really. After debuting back, I believe in 2013, alongside Fandango, but they parted ways and now she's just lost her edge, but she may even advance to the one-on-one match for the women's title at Backlash. I guess we'll have to find out. As you see, she looks very ready to go. Let's find out who the next person is. What woman? And it's the youngest of the two sisters, slightly younger, only probably about 1 minute or 1 second maybe. The lovely Brie Bella, obviously wanting to shine in her husband's footsteps, or follow it, I mean, in her husband's footsteps, who we all know she's married to Daniel Bryan, which would explain why she's wearing that flannel there. Let's find out who the next one is. And it is Naomi. She's got quite a family heritage now, ever since she married one of the Uso brothers. She's now in the league of, considered to be in the league of The Rock. She's representing The Rock, Roman Reigns, even the Usos, even the new Hall of Fame inductee, Rikishi. Who was inducted last year. And then let's just see who the next, who the fourth person to come out. Nope. The fourth or fifth, I lost count. Oh, and I think it's actually Naomi's tag team partner, who's also in that same heritage, but she's got her own heritage to pull, because we all know who her father is. Jimmy Fly, Jimmy Snooker. Superfly Jimmy Snooker. She is a Samoan herself. She is Tamina Snooker. And he looks ready to go. Guess there's going to be no friendships here, because she is related to family friendships, whichever one Naomi and Tamina like to call themselves. Actually, now I think about it, they were actually a full tag team that used to be in this thing. It used to be called Team Bad, which consisted of Tamina, Naomi and Sasha Banks. They parted ways. But here comes Eva Marie. I know what you're thinking. No, she can wrestle. I know I hear some of you in the crowd saying you can't wrestle. But don't forget who she's treading under. The great Brian Kendrick. And he's taught her quite a few things. Thing or two since he's trained under him, and who knows, maybe she might actually win. You never know. Right, let's just get this match started, I guess. Remember what this is for. This is for a chance to be in a match at Backlash. Oh, Sasha Banks straight off the gate goes towards Eva Marie. Oh, nice electric chair there by Spina. Oh, nice hit security there by Sasha Banks. Nice stomp there by Tamina Snuka. Oh, nice right hand there by Sasha Banks. Oh, nice big boot to Summer Rae by Eva Marie. If I'm gonna be honest with you, if I was to call this match, I'd probably say that it would be Brie that would win this. She probably gets training from her husband, as we all know, it's the Daniel Bryan. Oh, but Summer Rae trying to get Eva Marie out the ring. Oh, but Eva Marie's able to fight it off. Sasha Banks just working Tamina in the corner there. Oh, nice. Elbow straight, like knee straight into the face of Tamina. Nice. Sends Tamina out of the ring, but Tamina's able to hang on. Nice Irish rip into the corner. Oh. Brie's trying to eliminate Naomi. Tamina trying to throw Sasha out the ring. This time Sasha's just able to... Sasha Banks showing off once more. Oh, and Eva Marie shucks Summer at the ring. Yeah, she thought that she was out. Sasha Banks throwing Tamina out the ring. Nice quick struggle here. Summer Rae's trying to eliminate. And Tamina has been eliminated. Oh. Looks like Naomi's trying to eliminate Brie Bella. Oh, Eva and Sasha trying to work together to eliminate Summer Rae. Oh, a nice kick to the gut right to Eva Marie. I think she went for a bit of like a mania scoop slam, but or maybe a body slam, I don't know. Oh. Oh, nice move there by. Nice net breaker there by Sasha Banks. But Eva is able to reverse the Irish whip and just throws Sasha right out of the ring. Nice short arm clothesline there by Sasha Banks. Gets Eva up. Throws her over. Throws her over her shoulder. Oh, nice reversal. Trying to eliminate the boss. Oh, Irish whip. Now Eva's trying to think. And on the other side of the ring, you see Brie's trying to eliminate Naomi. And Eva Marie's out. Oh. Brie's trying to eliminate Naomi, and there goes Naomi. Literally, just as I almost nearly cursed it, but thought I would have done a curse to the commentator. Nice. Trying to get in the head of Brie Bella with Sasha Banks. Nice dropkick, one legged dropkick there by Sasha Banks. Right, Brie Bella, sorry. Throws out the ring. Oh, she's looking for it. Oh, it just kicks her straight to the head and Brie Bella's been eliminated. And it seems that Sasha Banks is going to go to Backlash. She is going. And who she'll be facing, we don't know yet. We'll find out that next week. To find out who she she'll be facing next week. Well, in 2 weeks at Backlash. Well done, Sasha Banks. And here we go with our last match of the first round of this tournament. It will be, as you see, Y2J. The master, the codebreaker, the Boston Crab, man of 1,004 holds, Y2J, Chris Jericho. Jericho looks ready for this match, as does his opponent, who you'll find out who it is in literally just a few moments. I'm pretty sure Jericho, who knows, maybe Jericho might even win this match against this opponent. After all, he is the first ever undisputed champion. Let's just waste no more time and let's find out who his opponent is. You'll be shocked to see who it is. Here we go. As you see, Chris Jericho looks ready to go. Yes, it is. It is the American Badass. The Dead Man. The Phenom. He is the Undertaker. As you see, the Undertaker's going back to his bike ways. But I'm sure probably down the line he may return back to his dead persona. But it'll be a while till we see that. We may not even see that. And Undertaker looks ready to get that holy grail and to win and become the first ever EHW champion. World champion. Here we go. Both these men look ready. Nice headlock there by Undertaker. Jericho throws him off the ropes. Oh, ducks and leaf. Oh, nice clothesline there by the Undertaker. Nice uppercut there by the Dead Man. Gets Jericho back up. Nice punch. Jericho's able to reverse it. Oh, tie up. Oh, nice arm lock. Undertaker gets out of it. Now he's got like a wrist lock. Could possibly break him. Break his arm there. Oh, another kick to the gut. Oh, a nice STO there. As you see there. Oh, Undertaker showing off to the fans. He seems to be the fan favourite here. Oh, now it's Undertaker pushing just Chris Jericho to the ropes. Throws him off. Oh, ducks underneath. Jericho is able to reverse it. Goes for a nice hip toss. Undertaker reverses it with a nice elbow. Nice fury of punches. No one before we've got the Dead Man, as they say. Nice Irish whip sends Undertaker to the apron. Oh, what's Jericho thinking here? Oh, just dangling. Oh, what a brutal neck breaker there by Y2J Chris Jericho. Oh, nice reversal there by the Undertaker. First few rear punches. Just on the ropes. Nice clothesline out of the ring. Undertaker just admiring his work. Let's jerk it back in the ring. Straight into a headlock. Oh, just puts him on his shoulder. Oh, nice. Flips him over. Gets him up. Oh, nice backbreaker there by Dead Man. Oh, nice neckbreaker there. Gets him up. Throws him into the corner. Looks like he was going for some sort of clothesline, but Joker's able to reverse it. Oh, and a nice. Oh, I thought he was going for a German there, but Undertaker was able to reverse it into a DDT there. What a beautiful move. Made famous by the man who actually beat. Actually, the man who beat Undertaker at WrestleMania about 2 years ago. I don't think that's making Undertaker stop. Stop though. Oh. Looks like he's going for the last ride. And the last ride is Jericho just destroying that back. Nice pin. One. Two. Oh, but Jericho's somehow able to kick out. Undertaker doesn't believe it. Kicks him up straight away. Goes for a punch, but Jericho's able to reverse it. Kicks him up. Oh, a nice Russian leg sweep there by the Undertaker. This match has all been him. Oh, nice punch. Nice kick to the gut. Nice few punches, but Jericho's able to reverse it into a nice punch. Oh, nice snap there. Oh, looked like he was going to go for some sort of like suplex or something. Undertaker was able to reverse it. Nice clothesline. Nice kick to the gut. Oh, nice. Body shots. Oh, nice punch. Oh, nice reversal there by Chris Jericho. Another reversal there by Undertaker. Chris Jericho cannot catch a break. Every time he gets a bit of offense in, Undertaker's right there to stop it. Oh, I think Undertaker's looking to go old school. He is. Goes up to the top rope. I still don't understand how he's able to do this. He's nearly 50 now and he's still able to do that. Makes no sense to me. Looks like Undertaker wants to end it. Here we go. Sets him up. And knocks him down. Right on his head. I think he might have busted him open just a tiny bit. But quick pin from the tombstone. And three. And Undertaker advances to the semi-finals of this tournament. Well done, Undertaker. And I believe next week he will face Batista. And if he wins that, he will go on to fight for the championship at Backlash. Well done, Undertaker. You deserve it. After all your hard work working for in this company. Well done, Undertaker. This has been the Lucky 13. You are the Extreme Universe. I am now signing.